I just picked something up for the beam that was an absolute necessity. One of the Uniden R7s. I don't have any tickets and I want to keep it that way. So I picked this bad boy up and I think the move is to try and wire it into the car nicely, because obviously we can have the wires kind of sitting down here, but that looks like trash. And let's be honest, no one wants to see cables when getting into the car. So I'm going to try and run the cable from here all the way up. I just took the A-pillar off, took off this little cover over here as well. And I'm going to hopefully try and run it some way down, or maybe not even up here for any reason. I would run it down there, over here, probably underneath, come back up, and then plug it in. We'll have a little bit of cable over here, but it is what it is. I don't have one of the cool, or one of the ports, unfortunately. Mine's just empty for some reason, because BMW hates me, apparently. All right, I got the cable kind of hanging out, doing its thing here. Brought it down, brought it underneath. I might try and clean this up just a little bit more, get it tucked underneath that back part there, but I got it up here. I pulled this little tray down, just pulls down, brought it up, and then here we are. Plugged it in right there, so there's no cable kind of sitting here. Like I said, I'm gonna try and clean that up real quick, and let's see how this looks all put back together. I think the greatest mod that I've ever done to it isn't really a mod at all, doesn't help performance, doesn't make the interior look any better, but does something that's so important that saves me probably the most money that you can save while owning a car. If you don't know what I'm talking about, then let me give you a slight hint.
X-band, K-band, KA-band, laser.
That's right, I'm talking about my Uniden R7 radar detector. This thing has been an absolute lifesaver. The idea of getting a ticket when you're my age, I'm 21 right now, so getting a ticket is absolutely detrimental to my driving record. It's gonna raise my insurance rate, it's gonna get me denied if I wanted to get a nicer car than this one in the future. Overall, it's just not a pleasant place to be. There have been quite a few times where I'm not even necessarily speeding. I might be getting onto a highway at a little bit faster of a speed than I normally am, but I'm just getting up to highway speeds. But even then, you're making a pass, you're going faster than you probably should be around a turn, getting onto the freeway, and you don't notice that cop that's coming flying up behind you. And in my case, that's exactly what's happened to me multiple times. I'm going to take an on-ramp, gunning it just a little bit too much, and as I'm getting on the freeway, I get hit. I get hit with some sort of K-band, and this radar absolutely saves me. These are expensive. You're probably looking at, for a decent radar detector, $300 and above. Now, that might be a little bit pricey in the beginning, but at the end of the day, it's gonna be cheaper than a ticket. Most tickets are gonna be upwards of $500, $600, $700, depending on the speeds that you're going and the circumstances, which I never wanna be in that position where I'm getting written one of those very expensive tickets. And this is just one of those investments that's gonna save me money in the long run. Some things that need to change on the channel. The car right now is amazing. Performance-wise, interior-wise, I'm pretty happy with where it's at, but let's be honest here. She's not really too much of a looker at this point. And don't get me wrong, the 2 Series is great. She's a performance beast, and if she's gonna be putting out the numbers that she's putting out, she needs to be looking the part. And so, we've got some big things coming for the car. I'm really, really excited to finally be able to make this car look how I've imagined it looking for about the past year or so. Finally bit the bullet, have some cool parts coming in. We're gonna be making some awesome videos on all those things, and I'm super excited. I feel like this car doesn't get the love that it deserves, and if there's anything that you want to know or see regarding this car, let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to hear what people think and what people want to see with this car. I wanted to talk to the camera and be real for a minute here. If you've been watching my videos for a little bit now, you probably have caught on that I like to have a little bit more of a fast-paced editing style, and I don't really keep too much in of what's going on behind the scenes or sort of the, I don't know, some of the filler that I think that other people on YouTube like to put out. And for me personally, it's just not interesting, but sometimes I feel like I just want to talk and kind of explain what I'm doing here with YouTube, and the goal is just to have fun. I like the idea of building a community within the car scene, especially within the BMW 2 Series scene. I feel like there really isn't too much 2 Series content on YouTube, especially for the M240i. I have a couple friends who have M235i's. You see a lot of 135 content, but as for the M240, I really feel like there just isn't too much going on in that scene. It was probably one of the bigger factors of me buying this car, is I wanted to put out unique content on a car that doesn't really get the light that it deserves. It never really gets the spotlight. And that's kind of my purpose with this. You see a lot of 340s, 440s, but M240 is a little bit more rare. And I find it cool that I have one of the few on YouTube that's gonna be doing some cool stuff. As 2023 has gotten here, I really feel more motivated this year than ever before. It's sort of cliche to be like, this is my year, but part of me just feels like this is my year. I really hate where I'm working, and I really enjoy filming videos, doing things with cars, whether that's going to car meets, working on my own personal car, or hanging out with friends in a parking lot till midnight, just talking about cars or nothing really at all, talking about life and what we want to do moving forward. And
yeah.